Sentinels the Multiverse. And we have finally reached the Wraith, Razor's Edge. The Wraith listened to the sounds of Obsidian's legacy flowing, carrying Absolute Zero. She tracks by to the Maze of Twisting Alleys, and it was only a matter of time before she hit her chance. So, there's actually a story that goes with this one shot. I believe it was a fan fiction to try to promote the character of Spite, and it was so well received it was actually integrated into the canon. It's supposed to be how Spite ultimately dies at Wraith's hands. And Spite is a nasty customer all around, unfortunately. I don't remember your face, but I remember the fear in your eyes. Delicious. Donovan, I should have known. I hadn't seen the last of you. Let's end this. So if you don't know how Spite works, he's kind of like Bane. That's the best way to describe him, I'd say. And for beating him, you have two options. Key thing is, you're not going to do anything until he flips. And he's not going to flip until he gets all of his drugs out. So, I'll explain the safe house and everything in a moment. He's taking shots at Legacy. So, Spite, 80 HP. Transhuman serial killer, so he has a dash of Zazz in here too, I guess. But his thing is the safe house. That's what makes him so unique. The thing about Spite is whenever he deals damage, he heals based off of how much damage he does, which is why stun darts are so valuable here. At the end of the villain turn, he plays the top card of the deck, then he attacks the target with the highest HP for energy damage. At the start of the turn, if there's 5 drugs in play, he flips, and since we're playing on advanced, he regains a flat 5 HP each turn. When flipped, he has 80 HP still. He's still the drug-racked monstrosity. And when he goes to this side, all villain cards other than drugs are destroyed, so he'll also take out the environment too, I believe. So whenever villain card will be played, Spite deals each hero other than the hero target with the lowest HP 1 projectile damage, so Stun Bolts deals with that for the most part. When he flips to this side, he regains hero times 5 HP, so in this case, 15, because we have 3 heroes. In the event you want to send a team of 5 against him, that means he'll get a 25 hit point heal. Not to be taken lightly. And he has a flat 1 damage reduction, because this is advanced mode. It's not supposed to make sense. Now, the safe house is pretty much where you can store the victims until you can permanently save them. And when he flips, this will damage him based off how many cards are under here times 5. So if you can get 3 cards under here, then you're going to cancel out his heal if you play things correctly. Now here we have 2 victims. You have the Good Samaritan. You have to let him play the top card of his deck, which is rarely a good idea. Lost Child, you can take some damage for this, but you don't want Wraith to ever take the damage because she is his nemesis. She'll take increased damage. So you have a couple options here. You can use the infrared eyepiece to try to stall, and that's really your best first move. But I should point out how Compound 11 works. When you use a power, Spite hits you for 2 toxic damage, and then he throws away 5 cards from your deck. You have no way to destroy his drugs. Once they're out, they're out, so you need to delay them from coming here. Now, since this is a one-shot, everything is scripted, he has Elaborate as his top card. Destroys all environment cards, then he will reveal until the at least a drug card comes out. So if you remember how it works, this will be played immediately after the environment turn, thus there will always be at least one, but it's possible you can get all of his drugs out in the right environment. And in case you're wondering what I'm talking about there, that'd be something like Silver Gulch, where you can get like 3 environment cards out all at once. He would be over the top there, if you ask me. So drug cards go into play, everything else goes away. We want to put the bystander on top. We got a Razor Ordnance, and we took 3 damage. There's our Stun Bolt. Yeah, he can attack him, I don't care. Lost Child, into the safe house, Spite heals, etc., etc. Now, the environment here... When I first looked at this place, I thought it was a somewhat friendly environment because you have stuff like Tony Torres, Dr. Tremada here. but the more I learn about this place, the more I realize how messed up it is, and you're better off playing Danger Sense. And now the hardest part about here is you need to know if you use powers, he's going to beat you down, so you actually have to wait. You have to build up slowly and steadily until you're able to finally give him the push. So you can put out either one of those, it really doesn't matter, and then just end your turn, because if you tried to heal yourself or something, he's just going to attack you and you're going to be worse off than you started. And like I said, we don't want to. So he's going to take a little bit of damage there, but the thing is, he's just going to heal. And then everyone takes an attack. So 5 damage from that one card. Demon's Kiss is another one of his drugs. Sadly, he's still gonna hurt Wraith, but we're worried about our teammates more than anything. And I know the secret to this is getting the smoke bombs out as soon as possible. So, right here, Inspiring Presence isn't gonna do anything right now because we don't hurt him enough. He's gonna keep healing. Rogue Interception isn't going to do much just yet. I could punch him, but I want to bolster allies so everyone gets a draw. We have a grappling hook. Gonna end turn. So I can use this. It's going to give me a card, which I can use to pull the transducer. Doesn't matter what I do here. There's Impale. That's one of the cards we're waiting on. Nope. I discard one card. Absolute Zero has a duplicate of this. So each player may discard one card. Any player that does may destroy an environment card. Let's skip since we can destroy the sludge. Scum and Villainy plays the top part of the deck. Samaritan. Collateral damage, so Samaritan's gone. Let's ice this one. And there goes the other Samaritan. Now, Spite does have ways to force people out of the safe house, which you'll be seeing momentarily, I'm afraid. Yes, I know the order of his cards. So we can do Mega Computer, but we're gonna get further by using the impromptu invention. That targeting here is gonna help significantly. But we need these smoke bombs out. So we can put these in play. This will deal with the environment. This will boost my damage, this will cause counterattacks, but the smoke bombs are going to prevent that, so we'll go for the targeting computer. And we'll try to cut into it a little bit. So the smoke bombs also give you a minus one, in case you're wondering. Stun bolts minus one, smoke bombs minus one, means nothing happens. So, I want to draw because I'm looking for more cards. That's one of the things that can really help here. You can make yourself immune to toxic and he doesn't do as much. Let's toss out Impale so we can start hurting him. Sadly, I think he is going to heal to full here, but we're getting getting close to the point where... drugs out so far, and with this I should be able to heal more than he can hurt. That's... yeah, I healed him. So I needed some discards there so I can fish out a cryo chamber. Sitting here watching this and not doing a damn thing, so he's gonna get what's coming to him. And in case you couldn't read between the lines, I just don't want to discard cards to save him. So, no, we don't. Do we want to discard? Yes, Trust Fund is not gonna help us here. I don't take any damage. Surge of Strength. I don't have much for offensive cards, I'm afraid. So we have a Cryo Chamber right there. Let's fish that out. Down one HP. Because I fully healed and I take one here. It's gonna fully heal him, yes, but it doesn't matter because he's going to flip anyway. Well, he heals when flipped, I mean. That's gonna get destroyed anyway by his collateral damage, so that's no loss. Thank you. So come on, I should actually show these now that I think about it. So Demon's Kiss. At the end of the villain turn, Spy deals each non-villain target one infernal damage. Cards are indestructible, etc., etc. Remind Fire, destroy all environment cards. Spy deals each hero X psychic damage, where it's based off the number of environmental cards destroyed. As for Upsilon, this increases Spite's damage. You put one hero ongoing or human card back into the player's hand. Now, keep in mind that one is hero minus two. So if you bring five guys here, that means three go into your hand. So yeah, I don't need the combat stance. Reduces the damage he takes by one. Potential sidekick. I can potentially get that into the safe house before he flips. That'll cause 25 damage to be taken. I can't afford to discard three cards here. I think I can for Legacy, though. So getting the second stun bolt out just in case, I can start double stun bolting him. So right there, that offsets his healing. Throw jab, that'll come in handy. And yes, I do. We can get rid of next evolution because I have one in play. Heroic interception. And we're going to get rid of Thok. I'm going to play this in the event I can actually start to contribute to the team's DPS. But what type of damage is it I'm taking? Energy. Oh well. Flying Smash is no help here because it's a solitary target. And I guess discarding cards would probably be better for Zero here, since he has a crap load. I want to go too crazy here, but I might not have much of a choice. Thank you. we want him to heal first. Doesn't matter about which of these get destroyed. And for the card to return to hand, I put out a stun bolt. I said I'd hold on to that. We'll use the eyepiece. We haven't used that in a while. So here. I think I die. Deals one hero X cold damage. So yeah, we can use that. Then we have to shuffle to death. Cold snap, that's a pretty handy card here. Let's just impale, I find a little bit better. To put out a sacrifice card to pick up next turn. And since we can take damage again, we need to hit him with a stun bolt. Sadly, we cannot triple stun bolt him. I know some of you were thinking that, but no, that's not how that works, I'm afraid. So right here, we can steer all the poison damage onto Legacy. He doesn't draw anything. Now, I think I can end him here if I play this. We're gonna try it. So I said I was going to play the Combat Stance as a sacrificial card. Legacy still takes that. No, Zero can take it. Damn it, he takes two, I forgot. Smoke Bombs because it gives you a minus one. You even though they're now tied. They beat Wraith and Zero. See if she's really worth all the hassle it takes to get her. But that's for another time.